So this is the video for 6.2 CI about the confidence interval for a single mean. Like we saw in the previous video, the way that we can approximate the standard error of the sampling distribution for a mean is with S over the square root of N. And that only works if N is large, like greater than or equal to 30, but that's the way that we're going to calculate our standard error. And then our generic method for making a confidence interval is to have the point estimate plus or minus the critical value times the standard error. And in this case, our critical value is an X bar plus or minus, and our critical value in this case is a T star value from the student's T distribution. And then we've got our standard error, where we're estimating the standard error to be S over the square root of N. And then we're gonna need to find a critical value for T star. It's not gonna be something that you can just kind of memorize like with the normal distribution. We're gonna have to look at a T distribution with a particular number of degrees of freedom, in this case, N minus one. So let's do an example. I've got data on a sample of 100 runners in the Cherry Blossom 10-mile race from 2019. So this is a run in Washington, DC. In the data set, the mean age of runners, X bar, is 35.45, and the standard deviation is 10.8. Sorry, my video might be covering that up. And we're gonna create a 90% confidence interval for the average age of runners. So we've got our point estimate, that's 35.45. We're gonna have our plus or minus T star times the standard error. And so now there's kind of two tricky things. We have to compute our standard error and we have to find our T star value. Let's start with the standard error. So the standard error is the standard deviation of 10.8 divided by the square root of N. And in this case, it was a sample of 100 runners. So that's gonna be 10.8 over 10, which is 1.08. So that's our standard error. So I'm just gonna erase this and I'm gonna put it in 1.08. And then the tricky thing is the T star value. So we're gonna look at a T distribution with N minus one degrees of freedom. And sometimes we abbreviate degrees of freedom DF. So in this case, N minus one is 100 minus one, which is 99. And then the way that we're gonna find the critical T value is we're gonna look at StatKey. So I'm gonna go over to StatKey. So here we are at StatKey. And in this case, we're gonna be looking at a theoretical distribution. It's not gonna be the normal distribution, it's gonna be the T distribution. So I'm gonna click on that. And as soon as I try and go in there, it's gonna ask me for the degrees of freedom. So that's gonna be the 99. And now this distribution looks a lot like the normal distribution because the T distribution is gonna converge to the normal as the degrees of freedom approach infinity, but it's actually a little bit different. And so then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click the two tail button, and by default, it's gonna give me the critical values for 95%. I'm gonna click where it says 0.95 and change that to 0.90 because I said we were gonna do a 90% confidence interval here. Okay, and then the critical value is 1.660. So we had 99 degrees of freedom. We changed this to 90%. So we had 90% in the middle and then 5% on either tail. And here's our critical value, our T star value is 1.660. So I'm just gonna go back a slide and I'm gonna take my, here's what I was working on. I'm just gonna write it again, 35.45 plus or minus 1.660 times 1.08. And that's gonna be 35.45 plus or minus 1.79, and so that's going to be 35.45 minus 1.79, and that's 33.66, and then 35.45 plus 1.79, and that's 37.24. So if I needed to interpret that, I would say I am 90% confident. The true mean age of runners is between 30, all round, 34 and 37 years old. That's our confidence interval. And then just like when we were doing one proportion, we've got a margin of error, a concept of a margin of error. That's the T star value times the standard error. And we might want to set a particular margin of error, which would then determine a sample size for us. So again, we're gonna solve for N to get a better formula. I'm gonna start by multiplying both sides of this by the square root of N. And maybe I'll write it at the top. Divide by the margin of error. And then we could square both sides. N is equal to T star times S over the margin of error, all that squared. All right, so here's our formula. We have two problems here though. And the first problem is if we were gonna figure out our T star value, we'd need to know N in order to compute our degrees of freedom. So we've got a solution, use Z star. So if we were gonna do a 95% confidence, we would use 1.96. Or if we were gonna use 90%, we'd use 1.645, et cetera. So Z star is not gonna depend on the degrees of freedom, so we can just use a Z value. The other problem is to know S, we would need data. So we don't know the standard deviation until we actually have the data. And then we have a solution for this as well. Well, there's lots of solutions. I'm just gonna tell you my favorite solution, which is estimate S by the range divided by 4. So you do the maximum minus the minimum and you divide by 4. And this is just a rule of thumb, but it works pretty well. And I'm gonna show you in an example. Okay. So let's say that we wanted to compute a confidence interval for the finishing times of that 10-mile race, such that the margin of error is within 5 minutes, and we want to know how large a sample size we would need. So we're going to have that formula, which is N equal to T star times S over the margin of error squared. I guess I didn't specify a confidence level, so let's assume 95% confidence. And so then we're gonna estimate T star with Z star equal to 1.96, because that's our critical value for 95% confidence. And then we need to estimate S. And so what we need the maximum minus the minimum over 4. And I'm not a runner, but I would sort of think that the minimum finishing time, I know like a 6-minute mile is a good mile time. So let's say that the minimum time would be 6-minute miles for 10 miles. I don't know if that's reasonable or not, but I'm just gonna guess that. And so 6 times 10, my minimum guess would be that it would take 60 minutes. And then the maximum, again, I'm not a runner. I think like it might take me 20 minutes to run a mile. So let's say that the maximum amount of time for this 10-mile race would be 20 times 10, so 200 minutes. So that's my guess, and we'll divide by 4. So that's 200 minus 60, that's 140 divided by 4, which is 4 is 35. So that's my estimate for the standard deviation. So let's see, N is equal to, and we're gonna plug in 1.96 for our T-star approximation. We're gonna plug in 35 for our standard deviation approximation, We wanted it to be within 5 minutes, so that's our margin of error. And then we're gonna square the whole thing. So I get 187.69, so I'm gonna say 188. So we would want to sample around 188 people to be able to have a margin of error within 5 minutes. All right, so our final thoughts, if n is large, like greater than or equal to 30, we can construct a confidence interval like this, x bar plus or minus t star times s over the square root of n. We can estimate our margin of error using z star times s over margin of error, that whole thing squared. And we can estimate s by the range over 4.